Welcome to Neoplasia. What does that mean to you? Proliferation of cells. It means that a cell is going to remain within the cell cycle for a long period of time, and depending as to its behavior, it may then go on to be more benign in nature or malignant. By the time we're done with this particular section, you will have then become an expert in the basics of neoplasia. Neoplasia, new growth, not reversible, is a key, even with benign. Remember, if a cell undergoes increased mitotic rate at some point in time within the cell cycle, meaning to say that you're in the M phase, very difficult to reverse that. Dysplasia, very important topic. For example, let's say that you have an organ that's undergone hyperplasia. At any point in time with hyperplasia, which means increased number, right? And one would think with hyperplasia that there might not be a tendency of going on to neoplasia. That is incorrect. For example, if there is endometrial hyperplasia that might be taking place in a patient who is above the age of 50, a female, I mean to say postmenopausal, and you start bleeding, you see bleeding coming out of cervical os. Kind of worried now, aren't you, that there is possibility of endometrial hyperplasia and then concerning of endometrial cancer. But it's not like hyperplasia just went into cancer, right? It has to go through a period of dysplasia. So put things into perspective. Or, for example, you've heard of HPV, and you've heard of higher strain, 16, 18, 31, 33, and you should be thinking about the cervix. And with the cervix, and in the developing country in the world, cervical cancer is a pretty big deal. But before it went into cervical cancer, what kind of changes did the cell of the cervix undergo? CIN1, CIN2, CIN3, cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. We have to call this dysplasia. So dysplasia is not neoplasia as of yet, but my goodness, is it close. And you, as a clinician, you hear the term dysplasia, you're absolutely worried about your patient going on to cancer. It's disordered growth, which is reversible, but unfortunately may result in neoplasia. As a rule of thumb, as far as you're concerned, even with the most severe or serious type of dysplasia in cervix, let's say CIN3, with that high-grade type of dysplasia, it still would take approximately a decade for that dysplasia to go on to cancer. Keep that in mind. Dysplasia is a very important topic for us. What is a tumor? A tumor is swelling. In basics, with tumor hemodynamics, we talked about histamine causing tumor. How was that possible? Histamine caused vasodilation, therefore bringing about enlargement. In this case, with basic neoplasia, we're dealing with increased proliferation of cells. Therefore, we have a tumor. And the behavior of that tumor could be either benign or malignant. We will be spending time with that. Now, before we move on, though, the other point of demarcation here would be malignant and metastasis. Just because you have a cancer or a neoplasia that is malignant, you're one step closer to perhaps metastasis, but malignant doesn't always have to go into metastasis. It's one step closer. So you're definitely worried about the increased proliferation and therefore causing rupture or penetration through the basement membrane. We'll talk further about this. And then we have actual cancer. Cancer would be malignant neoplasia. For example, if you have renal cell carcinoma or colorectal cancer, so on and so forth, then this type of cancer, you're worried about the membrane then rupturing and therefore entering spread. In other words, you've now gone onto the highway. What I mean by that is you've ruptured the membrane, you've entered the highway, and that highway, meaning to say either the lymphatic or perhaps the hematogenous spread. And once that happens, then my goodness, you're going to have spread of that cancer, well, step by step by step. Regional lymph nodes, from the regional lymph node, it might then go on to further lymph node, and then before you know it, there's widespread metastasis. How important is metastasis? If you remember, oftentimes the most common cancer within an organ is not primary, it'd be metastasis from a primary.